There are locations in California where the land appears so wide open, it would seem wildlife couldn't possibly have trouble existing and even thriving. Bears, mountain lions, bobcats, deer, and elk theoretically moving freely from one area to another in search of food, a mate, or shelter. Of course, that isn't the reality of California. Not with roughly 40 million residents and more than 16,000 miles of paved roads. Add in dams, canals, and rail lines to the mix, there are plenty of barriers that can prevent wildlife from thriving. What's known as habitat connectivity is critical for maintaining viable populations of wildlife species.
Make no mistake, connectivity is essential to life. It's key for us as people. I mean, who doesn't want connectivity to friends and family and social network? Same is true for animals. They need connection to habitat, places to live, to call home, to thrive, food and water. Freedom to roam. I mean, that right there summarizes the whole point of connectivity for animals, freedom to roam.
The California Department of Fish and Wildlife is actively engaged in finding solutions to the issue of wildlife barriers impacting movement and has recently updated a report titled Restoring California's Wildlife Connectivity 2022. This report is notable for identifying 62 priority barriers within the department's six land-based regions, with 12 of those recognized as top priority barriers statewide. A vast majority of the barriers are part of the state highway system. A handful are local roads or result from the state's high-speed rail alignments.
It's really exciting because barriers are one thing that we have control over. They're man-made, and so we can remediate them and fix the issues so that wildlife can move across the landscape. If it becomes isolated, the individuals and the population end up inbreeding, and that ends up over long periods of time causing detrimental effects and can eventually lead to the population dying out.
The new Wildlife Connectivity Report is significant because the information is expected to play a major role in assisting Caltrans with designing road projects that reduce the number of wildlife collisions. The recently signed Safe Roads and Wildlife Protection Act requires Caltrans to identify barriers to wildlife movement and prioritize crossing structures when building or improving roadways. Those structures could be overpasses like the recently approved Annenberg Wildlife Crossing in Agoura Hills, northwest of Los Angeles, and the Laurel Curve Project, a Highway 17 undercrossing in Santa Cruz County, on which construction is nearing completion.
It's increasingly important for Caltrans and all Californians to identify areas in need of improved access for wildlife connectivity. Caltrans looks forward to continuing to be part of the solution.
There are many reasons these state agencies are working to identify and reduce wildlife barriers. Habitat fragmentation can lead to inbreeding and genetic isolation for many species. Collisions take a toll on wildlife populations, while often seriously injuring the drivers in those crashes. UC Davis estimated the cost of animal vehicle conflicts in 2020 to be more than $180 million. California's 12 top priority barriers stretch from a section of Highway 101 north of Eureka in Humboldt County to a piece of Interstate 8 just north of the U.S.-Mexico border in Imperial County. The entire list of barriers with locations and lengths of roadways and the species they impact are included in the new report.
We've got funding from the legislature at the department and the Wildlife Conservation Board to invest in connectivity projects. We're finding actual projects on the ground with Caltrans, which is important for our partnership. Those are actual projects that's showing we can make a difference.
There may be dozens of barriers from one end of the state to the other limiting wildlife movement, but there are many undercrossings and culverts in existence that do allow wildlife the ability for widespread travels. The Western Transportation Institute, based at Montana State University, confirms that current structures, whether overpasses or undercrossings, can be highly successful in reducing wildlife vehicle collisions when they are well designed and placed in areas where animals are likely to cross. The CDFW report on Restoring California's Wildlife Connectivity 2022 is meant to advance that progress by continuing to improve the state's transportation infrastructure to be more wildlife friendly.
We can do this. California leads the world in so many ways. Right now, we need to become the leader on wildlife connectivity projects.